All right, we're back. So this time we're heading into the think tank again. And I'm gonna warn you, this episode's gonna be a lot of just dialogue. I mean, the last episode was too, so. But we're gonna. Wait, where the hell are they? Oh, I was like, where the fuck are these guys?
Dr. Have you come for hello? Oh, I'll give you a hello. A hello unsurpassed in all creation.
Okay, hello.
The lobotomite animal before me. What other terrifying terrors will plague us in our quest for knowledge? Communists? Communist animals, perhaps? Be warned. Attempt to propaganda me. I will shriek as a frightened babe, calling loyal cyber dogs to my aid. Do you comprehend, commie animal?
Do you always get this dramatic?
Drama? There is no drama in science. As I learned in high school, science is an intellectual pursuit devoid of bestial emotions. Unless, of course, you are a communist. Like Betsy Bright, who sat next to me in math, and her smoking Confederate Richie Marcus. As I learned in my high school, American High, AHS, drama is for movies, things of fiction. Here in the think tank, the only star is science.
Uh-huh. I encountered your pet in X8 and had to kill it.
So, you put down Gabe. Thank you. A scamp, but really, his highly augmented combat programming could have proved meddlesome. In any event, thank you for putting him down. One less test subject to catalog and sort. Clearly a failure of Doggy's cyboengineering.
Is this Gabe's bowl, your dog from X8, Gabe?
What? Why, yes, it is. I used to leave it outside his doghouse, chock full of cans, before the cybernetic modifications, of course. And no matter how chemmed the food, he would always eat it, and his tail would wag, even while I... You know, I'm having the most perplexing feelings squiggling through my biogel. I can't quite pin it down.
Sounds like Gabe really loved you.
Why, yes. Gabe. No matter how awful my day had been, he was always waiting there. How odd. My gel is decoagulating. And when I would talk to him about Betsy, and how Marcus would beat on me and call me smarty sissy pants, he'd just sit there, head on my knee, and... If you don't mind, I'll take that bowl. Just need to remove it. Put it away, somewhere out of radar range. For some reason... Its similarity to the crater shape of Big Mountain is starting to fill up all available cognitive spaces. That, combined with my own overwhelming feeling of having done something terrible, the two were hitting me with unexpected force.
It sounds to me like you hurt someone who loved you very much. I know that pain.
As odd as it is, I believe that is the conclusion. And I wonder why it didn't hit me before. Until I saw that memory in your hands. This sensation is unpleasant. I don't care for it. I don't care for this place either. And I feel as if we've forgotten something. Still, it... is no matter. Crush the feeling down. Crush it down. Push it into the loop. The... Yes. Forgotten. Almost. Yes? I do not need to remember anymore. Not today.
Okay. So who are you and what do you do here?
Before you is the brain of Dr. Boros, head of entomology, beastology, and DNA scrambling technology here at Big Mountain. I lay the bones and hearts of animals bare beneath my searing gaze, especially the dogs. I did so love dogs once. Especially Gabe, that rascal. But there are many animals to shape. Industrious cazadores, the happy-go-lucky night stalkers. They are my living, breathing DNA test tubes.
You're responsible for cazadores?
Indeed. Docile, curious, safe, sterile. They are contained here at Big Mountain to preserve DNA and for observation.
What makes you think they haven't escaped?
Because Big Mountain safety measures are far more sophisticated than their primitive animal instincts. We are their lords and masters.
Those things are all over the Mojave.
No, such creatures are found only here, for research purposes. They would no more be capable of escape than breeding.
I don't think they're sterile. They breed all right.
I cannot expect a lobotomite to understand the careful surgical castrating procedures used in their creation. Perhaps a demonstration of my castrating power would settle your doubts.
Go ahead. You might make me more fertile or impregnate me.
Impregnate you? What? Do you want to make me vomit inside my tank? The mere notion makes the edges of my biomed gel crystallize into asymmetrical patterns.
You don't seem to have a grasp on your own research.
Nonsense! That is what you speak. Nonsense from beyond. I was at the top of my high school class in American high school. I knew facts. I knew figures. I knew data.
Data.
We would know if our research was flawed. It is not. We never contradict ourselves. So do not even try.
All right. When did you create cazadores?
In 2000, let's see, carry the 3, then count backwards from the Great Static, or beyond. There were the tarantula debates, and something about hawks which made it around. 2003, May, Tuesday? It was definitely Tuesday. Why are we even debating this? What you ask is of null importance. Mobius besieges us. There are more important things to worry about than data and facts.
Want to know more about Mobius and the Forbidden Zone.
The malignant tumor that is Mobius plagues us all. His hunger for power, insatiable. From his lair in the Forbidden Zone, his terrifying robo-scorpion army clicks and whirs across the crater of Big Mountain, ever seeking, ever stinging. He must be stopped, or all of Big Mountain shall be destroyed.
Tell me about this radar fence.
The radar fence protects us all. If evidence is correct, the one who built it is me. It keeps anything with a disembodied brain inside, like us, and anything without a brain also inside. It is the ultimate defense against communist aggression. There'll be no infectious ideas on my watch.
Does it mean you're trapped here?
Trapped? Nonsense! We are secure here from evil philosophies. Ever since my anxiety-filled days of powerlessness and being bullied in American high school, I have dreamed of such security as the fence. That and giant cybernetic dogs that would ruthlessly patrol and kill anyone who wasn't my friend, like Richie Marcus and Betsy Bright. Who's laughing now, Betsy? I hope you and Richie are happy smoking in your radioactive coffins. I'm glad you never came to my birthday party.
Don't you want to leave?
No! Beyond is death, despite mounting evidence to the contrary. No matter where these strange humans wander in from with their ideas and new brains, there is nothing beyond Big Mountain.
Doesn't that prove you're wrong?
Enough! Stop filling my precious brain cell units with irrelevant data. You sound like the other visitors, making wild claims of a world beyond, where there is a war beyond war. It is unproven and unthinkable. Bother the other doctors with your crackpot theories. I have no time. None of us do.
Okay. Why does Klein want these particular technologies?
There is logic and purpose in it. If these technologies are needed to pierce the Forbidden Zone, so be it. Science is powerful, and in the right hands, our hands, if we had hands, we would be nigh unstoppable.
Can you tell me about the Big Empty?
That castrated nickname of our facility is not its true name. The true name is Big Mountain. Where are your manners? It is our home, threatened by the horrors of Mobius. All we wish to do is continue our research. Layer upon layer, above and beneath the floor of the crater, until we have our answers. But no, Mobius will not let us rest, scaring us with his scary robots with their laser tails and blowing up all the time.
Why have you leveled this place?
It was not our first choice of testing grounds, but we no longer have the luxuries of our test cities. Then we lost the mountain. After the explosion, we couldn't find it anymore. So the crater became our testing grounds for science.
What was this explosion?
Boom! Yes, quite unexpected and embarrassing. All better now after the landscaping, though. Much more pleasing to our monitors. And the crater helps keep everything inside, because it is bowl-shaped.
And test cities?
Yes. In the past, individuals would come to us, pay for technology, and if their town, community, or city was just right, we could use that city as a controlled experiment. Vault-Tec was much better at it, of course. We had to make do. Get permission. Sometimes. If only we could have used commie cities. But capturing whole cities was hard. So we captured enough commies to make cities of our own. So we had a group of Chinese prisoners to experiment on. Those were the days. But the true test was science on unsuspecting Americans. Whether it was holograms, new auto docks, toxins, vending machines, we wound them up, let them go into tiny isolated towns. Then we observed. Submit your questions. I shall respond with deadly answers.
deadly answers. Okay.
Until next time, then. Provided there is a next time. For any of us.
Yes. Well, that's one down. Four to go. This one shouldn't be too long because he can't actually talk. Can you speak? Do you understand me? Something happened with your voice module? It's too bad or good or something. Can I ask you some questions? Who are you? Sounds important. Do you know anything about Dr. Mobius or the Forbidden Zone? Alright. Just calm down. Didn't mean to alarm you. Can you tell me about these technologies Klein wants? You sound agitated, or you're percolating or something. Tell me about the big empty, big mountain that is. Sound a little down. You're emitting characters in patterns of 8, bracketed with tone adjustment at the end. Yeah. Well, I just heard the rhythm and the sequence is all. Life is patterns, you just gotta let the unconscious process them. I agree, if someone would take the time, you're more than just sound effects in a tank. If that's Robco Termlink protocol, doesn't that mean it can be hacked? If that's term link code, don't worry, I'm not going to take advantage of your exposed code. No problem, I know what it's like to be experimented on. Can you tell me about the sonic emitter? Riveting dialogue. It's incredibly fun to watch. Well, projecto is kind of evident. Emitter works better. No, I've been there. Higgs Village, right? Your house is there. So there's emitter code in your house in Higgs? Fan of opera, huh? Alright, jukebox is installed in the sink. Got it. I got the emitter fully upgraded. I'm happy too. Can't let this thing gather dust. Are you okay? You look really happy. You should be proud. It's a nice device. Oh, hey, thanks. Don't want it to run out. You're right. How did you fire up the sonic emitter when I arrived? Nothing to be embarrassed about. It's just best to keep that stuff private, you know? I'll be going now. Cool. Alright, we probably got time for one more.
I don't understand how you can stand those leg things.
Well, the penis toes help support them.
Breaking news! Talking lobotomite arrives in Think Tank. Its purpose, unknown. Undefinable. Its presence here, impossible.
I think you mean impossible.
Oh, really? Now the lobotomite is a master of the dictionary arts. What, do you have a doctorate in verbology? No? I do. And stop the presses. Just in from my eye monitors. Is that Rob Kotek on your arm? It is. What's your agenda bringing that in here?
Why do you have a doctorate in verbology? I mean, did you actually want a doctorate in verbology? Or were you required to get it? Like, what is your interest in verbology? What, my Pip-Boy?
How dare you bring Rob Kotek in here? What are you showing off? How great Robert House and his big company are?
Ooh, we can make Securitrons better than any robot those geniuses at Big Mountain can make, and they'll last 1,000 years.
You're lucky I don't have hands to tear that dip boy off your arm, or feet to stomp on its stupid metal guts. Damn Robco.
Calm down, just wanted to ask some questions.
Fine. Ask.
What do you do here?
All things robotical. You see a robot? I made it. See a broken robot? I made it that way. Deconstructed it down to parts. I have a gift with machines. I can render anything inoperable. Preserve them in a non-functioning state.
Doesn't sound impressive, breaking machines, that is.
Who asked you? You just wait until a working machine threatens you, and you'll wish I was around.
Tell me about Mobius and these monsters of his.
The genius Mobius somehow cobbles together these really impressive-looking robot scorpions with spare parts. Even painted them. Tried to see what makes them tick. Can't even examine them without them detonating all over me. Left with shrapnel and burns. Every time. Supposedly, he has even larger models, even a giant robot scorpion, hidden deep within the Forbidden Zone. Yeah, right. Giant monsters, sure.
A giant robot scorpion?
Yeah, crazy, right? Something right out of a midnight science fiction feature. Ridiculous. What are the odds?
Do you have another name?
Yeah, I do. It wasn't always O. I just took that one by default because sometimes it's easier to accept the mistake as long as the purpose works. I don't want to get into it. It's a sore topic with me. Makes my gel ripple.
Are you sure? I'm a good listener. Got the ears for it.
Great! Psychology! Clearly the worst of the sciences, right after cholestodiuretics. Okay, so my name isn't O. Never was. It was circular, a single character, digit, but not O. But even with enhanced sensors, no one here could get it right. Always kept seeing the letter, not the number.
They kept confusing the letter with the number. Your name is Dr. Zero.
Yes, thank you. Zero. I am Zero. How hard is that? A narrow, thin zero.
All right, so you want me to call you Zero, or?
Zero's my name. I'm proud of it, all right? It doesn't get the recognition it deserves. Truth be told, my emotional attachment to it doesn't even register compared to just having people recognize the difference. It's just that they're both sort of round and hollow, so when they monitor scan them, they assume that, oh, it's O. Vivisect me, please. Fine.
Hold on. Let me get some mentats in.
Predictable. The lobotomite specimen returns. Its purpose? Repetition. Chances of success? High.
I'd like to talk to you about your name.
What about it? I don't feel like arguing it with you, too.
If you wanted to differentiate the O and Zero, just put a slash through the Zero.
What?
Yeah, I mean, that's what I do at work. Zero. Draw a slash through it.
Did I shoot myself with a brainial beam or something? That's brilliant! I mean, I would have come to the same conclusion. Eventually. Who am I deceiving? I never would have figured that out. I can't figure anything out. I'm useless.
So is that what you want to be?
Exactly. At least the old name was indisputable. Oh is more like surprise. Oh, look what I stepped in.
Well, there's power in Zero. It reduces anything multiplied against it to zero.
Well, of course it does. That's the most lethal of mathematics. That's pretty cool, actually. Destroyer of numbers. I already wreck every robot I study. Why not basic arithmetic? I like your solution. With that kind of slash in the middle, I can set myself apart. If I wanted to. The biggest Zero in all the think tank. They won't be able to escape it. That diagonal slash right down the middle. Thanks. Talking to you, it really helped unclog some frustration. Talking. What a primitive form of thought kicking.
So Zero, got any amazing discoveries to share?
You know, hearing my name said like that, it really de-resses my screens. As for discoveries, well, of course. Look at this. Just, built it. Amazing, isn't it?
It certainly is interesting, whatever it once was.
You know what? I'm not even gonna pretend. I broke one of the monitors, and those innards start falling out everywhere. If you could just hold on to that for me until, well, forever, that would be welcome.
Can you tell me about this facility?
Big Mountain used to be a mountain. Then there was a slight mishap. Now it's a crater. The dome used to be buried, now it's exposed to the sky. Don't get me wrong. Makes the sky light up like a planetarium at night. All those spectra. So soothing.
I need more of those worthless caps to test the CIU barter functions upstairs.
I'd have a few left. Let me check. Yeah, there were a few under the monitors here. Here you go. Keeps the place tidy.
Yeah, just 50 bottle caps lying under a monitor.
Until our next scheduled audio transmission and reception, then.
Man, I should start saying that on the phone. Alright. Well, we're gonna cut here. Next, we'll just do Dala and Dr. Klein. See you then.